Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with News Tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. 24 AIA DMK MPs in the Lok Sabha suspended for the rest of the winter session. Speaker Sumitra Mahajan takes action under Rule 374A. Suspended members had been obstructing the proceedings over the Kaveri Dam issue. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley rebuts Rahul Gandhi's charge on Rafael deal, says Congress is playing with the security of the nation. Opposition parties demand a joint parliamentary committee investigation into the deal. Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu underscores need to complete pending legislative business, holds two rounds of meetings with political party leaders to ensure smooth conduct of proceedings, says behaviour of few MPs is tarnishing the image of the House. Union Cabinet decides to constitute high-level committee to implement Assam Accord. Home Minister Rajnath Singh announces approval for merger of Vijaya Bank, Dena Bank, Bank of Baroda. And five miners rescued in Meghalaya's East Jayantia Hills district. 17 miners have been trapped in the flooded Rat Hole coal mine since 13th of December. Our top focus tonight, the Lok Sabha held a discussion under Rule 193 on the Rafael issue on Wednesday. Targeting the centre, Congress President Rahul Gandhi questioned the government's intent in making a fresh deal with escalated prices. He also questioned the process and pricing in procuring 36 Rafael fighter jets from France.
Did the Air Force change their demand for the number of planes? Or did you unilaterally, without asking the Air Force, change this demand? Why did the price go from 526 crores to 1600 crores?
Members of other opposition parties also demanded a JPC investigation on the Rafael deal. However, the discussion could not be completed due to disruptions and the House was adjourned till Thursday.
Why 1670 crores instead of 526 crores? Why 36 jets in place of 126 jets? Why not you gave a fresh discussion with Eurofighter?
We would have a capacity to manufacture these planes for the future. This, madam, has been sorely let gone off by the current NDA government. And if the difference of pricing is not enough to justify it, and I think the government should come up with a white paper as to why technology transfer was not given.
वो लड़ रहा है, उसको जिस जे है राजनीतिक दल हम सरकार है किसी भी सरकार होने दो, उसका एक काम था कि वो जब जरूरत बोल रहे कि हमें चाहिए, हम दे नहीं पा रहे, वक्त पे दे नहीं रह पा रहे.
He paid for 36 aircraft is about 60,000 crores, madam. It is nearly 2.5 times what the government states in parliament. So I would like the honourable defence minister to explain the discrepancy and how come you are paying more than 2.5 times for Rafael.
Benchmark price ठीक करना था, उसके बाद बाकी negotiation होते, लेकिन प्रधानमंत्री जी पहले ही घोषणा कर दिए benchmark price करने से पहले.
कहना चाहता हूँ कि court ये defence का मामला होने की वजह से वो सही फोरम नहीं है चर्चा करने के लिए, क्योंकि ये डिफेंस का मामला है वहाँ चर्चा नहीं हो सकती, इसका सही फोरम अध्यक्ष जी जॉइंट पार्लियामेंट्री कमेटी है.
Speaking during the Rafael debate in the Lok Sabha, Finance Minister and former Defence Minister Arun Jaitley rebutted all charges made by the Congress. He accused the Congress of playing with the national security. Jaitley asserted that the weaponized aircraft was 20% cheaper as compared to the one negotiated by the UPA.
The Congress party which has in the past been headed by great legends, is today headed by a gentleman who doesn't even have a basic understanding of what a combat aircraft is. They did not understand national security. They only understand paisa, to use his own word. मेरा ये आरोप है कि यूपीए सरकार ने इस देश की सुरक्षा के साथ खिलवाड़ किया। 2001 से फौज मांग कर रही थी और 2012 में मंत्री जी लिखते हैं कि मैं रफाल को मंजूरी देता हूं, लेकिन जिस प्रक्रिया से ये तय किया है उसके ऊपर पुनः विचार किया जाए। ये 2012, 2014 तक कुछ नहीं हुआ। बेसिक एयरक्राफ्ट का दाम 2016 की तारीख में यूपीए के दाम से 9% सस्ता था। वेपनाइज्ड एयरक्राफ्ट का दाम यूपीए के दाम से 20% सस्ता था। और कम से कम उस समझौते को एंटनी साहब से आप समझ लेते, यूपीए का जो समझौता था कि जब आप कॉन्ट्रैक्ट पे हस्ताक्षर करोगे तो 11 साल लगेंगे सप्लाई करने में।
Arun Jaitley also rejected the opposition's demand for a JPC probe, saying since the Supreme Court was satisfied on the issue, there was no need for a JPC. He also claimed that the JPC is a partisan body which can't investigate fairly. Launching a sharp attack against the Congress, Finance Minister Jaitley said the Congress is manufacturing a lie to defame the government, while the party itself is embroiled in scams like Bofors, Augusta Westland and National Herald. He also responded to the opposition's charges over the choice of offset partner.
The judgment says we asked for the prize in order to satisfy the conscience of the court. The government placed the prize before us. We opened the envelope, we read the prize, and after going through it, we don't think it is a case where we would like a judicial review of the pricing at all. सुप्रीम कोर्ट की कॉन्शियस सेटिस्फाई हो गई, लेकिन कांग्रेस पार्टी की चुनावी जरूरत उससे सेटिस्फाई नहीं हुई। 58,000 करोड़ का पूरा डील है, ऑफसेट हुए 29,000 के अगले 10 साल तक टोटल। उसमें 100-120 ऑफसेट सप्लायर होंगे। जिस कंपनी का नाम लिया गया, डसॉल्ट ने कहा हम उनसे 3 या 4% खरीदेंगे। 3 या 4% बनता है 800 करोड़। उस 800 करोड़ को कह दो वो ऑफसेट सप्लायर है। राहुल जी मानते हैं कि वो रफाल का मैन्युफैक्चरर है।
And Congress President Rahul Gandhi today claimed that the Rafael deal file is with Goa Chief Minister Manohar Parrikar. He also requested Lok Sabha Speaker to allow him to play the audio clip alleging involvement of Goa Chief Minister. However, Sumitra Mahajan didn't permit, citing rules of the House. Soon after, the lower house got adjourned for the day. Congress President held press conference where he played the alleged audio tape. He also reacted strongly on Finance Minister's speech in the House.
The audio tape is a recording of a minister, health minister, in the Goa government, and he is stating clearly, साफ बोल रहे हैं कि परिकर जी ने कैबिनेट मीटिंग में बोला कि मेरे पास राफाइल की फाइल है, पूरा का पूरा इंफॉर्मेशन है, और मुझे कोई डिस्टर्ब नहीं कर सकता है क्योंकि ये मेरे हाथ में है।
Banks. Soon after the press conference, Finance Minister Arun Jaitley responded on Twitter, questioning Rahul Gandhi's knowledge about the Rafael deal. He said that Congress president is unable to differentiate between the price of a flyaway aircraft and a weaponized jet. And Lok Sabha Speaker took action on Wednesday against members causing disruptions in the House. 24 AIADMK members were suspended by Lok Sabha Speaker Sumitra Mahajan under Rule 374A. The rule allows the Speaker to suspend members in the event of grave disorder, exemplified by a member coming into the well of the House or abusing its rules. The members have been suspended for the next 5 sittings in a row for disrupting the proceedings of the House. The AIADMK members had been protesting over the issue of protection of Kaveri Delta farmers in this session. They trooped into the well with placards and had been disrupting the proceedings of the House.
By your willful and persistent obstruction, grave disorder is being occasioned. I am therefore constrained to name you under Rule 374A. Therefore, all of them stand automatically suspended from the service of the House for 5 consecutive sittings of the session.
And Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu on Wednesday expressed deep anguish over the repeated disruptions in the House and voiced concern, noting that the image of the Parliament is taking a beating. He appealed to the members for the smooth functioning of the House as only 4 working days were left in the current winter session. He reiterated that notices for discussion on several issues have been admitted and urged the members to engage in meaningful debate and dialogue.
In an endeavour to restore normalcy in the House, Chairman urged the members to cooperate and ensure that the House functions in a meaningful manner for the remaining days. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu emphasised that notices on crucial issues have been admitted and discussions must not be stalled due to disruptions. The Chairman has consistently maintained that all issues will be allowed to be discussed in the House under relevant and appropriate rules.
The other House is functioning. Bills are getting approved. And we are not able to function here. I earnestly appeal to all of you, whatever issues you have, please come to me. If they are already not admitted, I will consider it positively. And secondly, any issue cannot be dictated. You do this way, then only we will allow the House. This is not acceptable in the system. And the House started on 11th December. Today we are on 2nd January. We have not been able to do anything. So please understand this, and the entire country is watching us. Once again, I would like to say, because I have habit of going around and addressing universities, scientific community, convocations. Whenever I go, and also when I come across the media, mazak uda rahe log. And that causing a loss of image to the House. So keeping ye parliament ke bare mein, जो लोगों का मन में जो भावना है वो गिर रहे प्लीज प्लीज द इमेज ऑफ पार्लियामेंट इज टेकिंग ए बीटिंग दैट्स व्हाई पीपल आर लाफिंग एट अस आई एम नॉट एबल टू डाइजेस्ट इट एज अ चेयरमैन ऑफ दिस हाउस आफ्टर ऑल यू आर ऑल सीनियर मेंबर्स आई डोंट वांट दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ सिचुएशंस इन द हाउस आई अर्नेस्टली रिक्वेस्ट ऑल ऑफ यू अगेन प्लीज कोऑपरेट सी टू इट दैट दिस हाउस फंक्शंस फॉर द रिमेनिंग डेज इन ए मीनिंगफुल मैनर एंड देन पास सम लेजिस्लेशंस हैव सम डिस्कशन दिस इज माय अपील टू ऑल ऑफ यू
The winter session of Parliament commenced from 11th December. However, repeated disruptions have paralyzed the proceedings of the House. The upper House, however, has passed the National Trust for Welfare of Persons with Autism, Cerebral Palsy, Mental Retardation and Multiple Disabilities Amendment Bill 2018. The productivity of that of Rajya Sabha in the winter session of 2017 was 56.29%. Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
The Parliamentary Standing Committee on Health and Family Welfare will examine the Allied and Healthcare Professions Bill 2018. The Rajya Sabha Chairman referred the bill to the committee today. The committee headed by Ram Gopal Yadav will submit its report on the bill within 3 months. Union Minister for Health and Family Welfare, J.P. Nadda, had presented the bill in the Upper House on 31st January 2018. The bill provides for standardized education and services for healthcare professionals. It also proposes that government set up the Allied and Healthcare Council of India that will be responsible for policies and other facts related to it. And a high-level committee will provide recommendation on how to provide constitutional, legislative and administrative safeguards to the indigenous people of Assam, including by reserving seats in the State Assembly. The decision was taken at a cabinet meet chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday. Home Minister Rajnath Singh said that the decision has been taken according to the Assam Accord signed in 1985. He said that the panel will hold discussions with all stakeholders and assess the required quantum of reservation of seats in Assam Legislative Assembly and local bodies for Assamese people. The committee will also examine the effectiveness of the actions taken since 1985 to implement Clause 6 of the Assam Accord.
कैबिनेट ने यह फैसला किया है कि एक हाई लेवल कमेटी कॉन्स्टिट्यूट की जाए जो कि असम एकॉर्ड की क्लास 6 में इनविशेस्ड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल लेजिस्लेटिव और एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव सेफगार्ड्स के बारे में अपनी रिकमेंडेशंस दे. यह हाई लेवल कमेटी 1985 से लेकर आज तक एकॉर्ड की क्लाज 6 के इम्प्लीमेंटेशन में किए गए एक्शन की इफेक्टिवनेस को भी एग्जामिन करेगी कि 85 से लेकर अब तक असम एकॉर्ड कितना लागू हुआ है. जो कुछ भी थोड़ा बहुत यदि हुआ है तो उसकी उसका प्रभाव कितना रहा है. उसे सभी स्टेक होल्डर से डिस्कशन करके असम लेजिस्लेटिव असेंबली में रिजर्वेशन के लिए क्वांटम के बारे में भी ये रिकमेंडेशंस करेगी.
द कैबिनेट आल्सो अप्रूव्ड मर्जर ऑफ देना बैंक एंड विजया बैंक विद बैंक ऑफ बड़ौदा टू मेक इट अ ग्लोबली कॉम्पिटिटिव लेंडर. विद द मर्जर बैंक ऑफ बड़ौदा विल बिकम द थर्ड लार्जेस्ट बैंक आफ्टर स्टेट बैंक ऑफ इंडिया एंड ICICI बैंक.
बैंक ऑफ बड़ौदा ट्रांसफरी बैंक है और देना बैंक और विजया बैंक ट्रांसफरर बैंक है. अब ये दोनों बैंक के मिलने के बाद अधिक सुचारू रूप से काम करना, अधिक कैपिटलाइजेशन, अधिक लेंडिंग की क्षमता, ये सब होगी. एंड दिस मर्ज्ड एंटिटी विल आल्सो हैव ए ग्लोबल कॉम्पिटिटिव आइडेंटिटी.
And to get a wider perspective on this, we'll go across to Mr. K.A. Badrinath, Editor, Policy, Financial Chronicle. Sir, thank you so much for coming to Rajya Sabha Television. Sir, government has decided to set up a high-level committee for the implementation of Clause 6 of the Assam Act. First of all, what is the Clause 6 and how important is it for the people of Assam? And I'll club my second question also with it, that why was the need for this committee and what will be its role?
See, the issue here is that in the late 70s and early 80s, when the Assam agitation happened, finally leading to the signing of the Assam Accord in 1985, the issue was that a lot of powers, legislative, administrative, and financial powers for the indigenous Assamese was to be reserved. And this Clause 6 clearly specifies as to what are these powers, how these need to be implemented, and how the local people can benefit out of the legislative provisions that will be there in the accord, as a fallout of the accord. Mm-hmm. But for several reasons, both political as well as administrative exigencies, this clause remains unimplemented till date over the last 30-35 years. Mm. Now, what the government seems to be doing is that a high-level committee, perhaps it will be headed by the Home Minister Rajnath Singh himself, to understand why it has not been implemented, how the domestic or local Assamese have been ignored over the years in terms of jobs, in terms of education, in terms of reservations in legislatures, local bodies, then also bureaucracy, that kind of thing. Because if you see, Assam has a huge, you know, contingent of the Bengali population living there, and maybe to an extent some little bit of Oriya population there, and there is a lot of migration, and also a lot of Bangladeshi immigrants or the infiltrators have come in and eaten into the benefits that should have been otherwise going to the local Assamese. So this clause, if implemented, we'll see that the domestic Assami ethnic population will get a better deal in terms of finances, in terms of legislative representation at the assembly, at the local bodies, and the panchayats, as well as the corporations that are there for Dibrugarh, Guwahati, and New Bongaigaon, and other places. So my guess is that it's a long, long haul for the Assami people. And also, as an outcome of this accord, also was that the Bodos, which are another big sizable population, should have been given a huge, you know, better deal in terms of economic benefits.
Yeah.
There was a Bodo, separate Bodo agitation. After which,
in fact, the cabinet has also approved a number of measures to fulfill the outstanding issues related to the Bodo community. Very quick, Mr. Badrinath, I'll come to my second question. The cabinet also approved the merger of Dena Bank and Vijaya Bank with the Bank of Baroda to make it globally competitive lender. Now, how will this merger help in serving this cause?
Okay, the merger was first proposed by the finance minister in the budget of 2018 and 19, and he said there's a merger that needs to be taking place. Mergers and acquisitions was one way of dealing with the bad loans or the sticky loan or the non-performing assets that are there in the public sector banks, private banks, foreign banks, as well as cooperative banks. But the stickiness is very huge in terms of state-run banks or the central government-owned banks. There are about 21 banks. In that, about 9 banks, there has been a huge issue because more than 30% or 40% of the loans have turned bad. So, one way of doing it was to bring about a merger and acquisition of these three banks, which will be one of the largest post-independence. And also, it's a fact that all the three banks have their own strengths and weaknesses. In the sense that, as you were saying it in your report, it will be the third largest bank after State Bank of India and ICICI Bank.
Absolutely.
Number one. Second issue is that this bank is going to have a lot of relative strength. For example, the Dena Bank has a lot of small depositors.
Absolutely. Mr. Badrinath, we are really falling short of time, so I'll have to stop you there. Thank you so much for joining us for such a wonderful discussion and getting us all the perspective on that very important development of the day, where cabinet decisions on two important issues, two important areas have come into the forefront. Moving on to some more news, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu handed over the 6th growth connection to the beneficiary under Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana today. Government's flagship scheme completed 60 million consumer mark earlier this week after the reach of the cooking gas scheme was extended to all in the poor in the country. Pushed by the scheme, overall LPG penetration in India increased from 62% in 2016 to 90% now.
Paryavaraniya drishti se saaf sudhare harit indhan ka uparabdh na hona. ग्रामीण दुर्भर वर्गों में बीमारियों की बड़ी वजह रही है कई पीढ़ियों तक घर की महिलाओं ने अपने स्वास्थ्य और अपने जीवन धुओं से भरे काले रसोई घरों में खपा दिया है आज जब एलपीजी जैसा स्वच्छ ईंधन उपलब्ध हो तभी ऐसी दुर्गति क्यों होना चाहिए दुर्दशा और दुर्गति बनी रहने देना हमारा अपराध ही मान जाता है इसलिए ये योजना बहुत महत्वपूर्ण है
And some more national developments. 5 miners have been rescued from the flooded coal mine in Meghalaya's East Jayantia Hills district. 17 miners have been trapped in the 370-foot deep illegal rat hole coal mine in Meghalaya since 13th of December after water from a nearby river flooded the mine. Divers of the Indian Navy, NDRF teams and are continuing the rescue operations to evacuate the remaining miners. Meanwhile, the Supreme Court agreed to hear a plea on Thursday seeking urgent steps to rescue the trapped miners. And Kerala's Sabarimala temple was shut today for what they say are purification rituals after two women devotees below 50 years of age entered the temple early morning today. Kerala Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan confirmed that two women entered the temple today and the state has issued standing orders to the police to provide all possible protection to any woman who wants to enter the temple. The temple was opened yesterday evening for 21-day Makara Vilakku festival. And celebrated cricket coach Ramakant Acharekar, who discovered and shaped one of the world's greatest cricketers, Sachin Tendulkar, is no more. The 87-year-old cricket coach had been battling age-related ailments for the past few days. Acharekar is best known for being the childhood coach of Sachin Tendulkar, whom he trained at Shivaji Park in Mumbai. He was bestowed the Padma Shri Award in 2010. Other than Tendulkar, he also coached Vinod Kambli, Praveen Amre, Sameer Dighe and Balwinder Singh Sandhu. Paying an emotional tribute to his former coach, Sachin Tendulkar said in a statement that he learned the ABCD of the game under his able guidance. And that's all we have for you in this edition. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.